just write it down, completing the square. Now, sa pag-complete ng square, you have to be careful, okay? Let's say, for example, we have, okay, that is x squared plus 10x plus 24 equals 0. In this case, students, you have to be careful. Dapat alam natin yung ax squared dyan, alam natin yung bx, and alam natin yung c. Yung ax squared dyan is our x squared dyan, yung first term. Yung bx is obviously yung middle term, that is 10x. And then yung C is our constant, that is 24. But students, you have to be careful with the sign. Okay? Nag-check ko lang na positive tayo lahat, so walang problema. Pero once may minus dito, you have to be careful with the sign. Okay, I want you to take note of BX because we are going to use it later. Wala? Yan yung dapat natin tandaan sa completing the square, yung BX na term. Mabalik tayo dito sa equation. What are we going to do here? First step here is we have to transpose the constant to the other side of the equation. So yung constant natin dito is 24. Transpose to the other side, yung matitira is x squared plus 10x. And that is equal to, from positive, magiging negative 24. Right? And then, in this case, again, sabi ko kanina, take note of bx. Bx is equal to 10x. So ano yung b dito? Hanap mo natin is yung b. Okay, students, yung B is yung katabi ng X. Dito, ano katabi ng X? That is 10. Therefore, yung B natin is equal to 10. Kasi pag sa completing the square, ang process natin dyan is, ina-add natin ang B, yung half ng B, then ang square niya, ina-add natin both sides of the equation. So, since yung half ng B natin is, yung B natin is 10, that would be 10 over 2 quantity squared. Again, students, ganito yung dapat niyong tandaan sa completing the square. Okay? 10 over 2 divide, 10 over 2 quantity squared. So, 10 over 2 is 5 squared and that is equal to 25. Anong gagawin sa 25? Add that to both sides of the equation. So, that would be x squared plus 10x plus 25. That is equal to negative 24 plus, again, both sides of the equation. Or kung ano yung inadd natin sa left side, dapat add din sa right side. That is plus 25. Kuha? And then of course, we proceed by, again, factoring na tayo. This is factoring perfect square trinomial. Okay? So that would be, ano yung square root ng x squared? X. Ano yung sign ng middle term? That is positive, so plus. And then ano yung square root ng 25? That is 5. Put a square. Okay? And that is equal to, yung negative 24 plus 25 is positive 1. Nakuha? And then, put the square root both side of the equation. Para makancel yung square, makancel yung square root. Yung matitira is x plus 5. And that is equal to, ano yung square root ng 1, students? Dalawa. Positive and negative 1. Kasi positive 1 is 1, negative 1 is still 1. Nakuha? And then, we have to transpose 5 to the other side of the equation. So, that would be x equals, so from positive, magiging negative 5, positive or plus minus 1. Now, students, we have two equations here. Again, pakitake note of plus minus 1, that is two equations, that is equivalent to two equations. What are those? That is x equals negative 5. Unahin natin yung plus 1. And the other is x equals negative 5. Then, tapos na tayo sa plus minus 1. Okay? And then, that would be negative 5 plus 1 is negative 4. And then, the other one is x equals negative 5 minus 1 is negative 6. So, therefore, we have two solutions. That is x equals negative 4 and x equals negative 6. Okay? Let's proceed with the last one. The last one is again, we are going to use the quadratic formula. Now, sa paggamit ng quadratic formula, students, medyo magiging complicated lang again siya. And dapat alam nyo kung paano i-derive yung formula. But in this video, I'm just going to show you the formula para mas mabilis tayo. Okay? But anyways, siguro, once hindi ko kayo sa video ito, siguro binigay na rin sa inyo ng teacher niyo yung quadratic formula natin. Okay? So again, yung four processes by using quadratic formula. Na pag sinabi natin quadratic formula, that is, wait lang, formula. So, that would be x is equal to negative b, okay? Plus minus square root of b squared minus 4ac. Okay? That is all over 2a. Yan yung quadratic formula natin. Nakuha? So let's say for example, we have 12x squared, okay? Plus 7x minus 12 is equal to 0. In this case, students, we have to identify kung ano yung a, ano yung b, ano yung c, kasi nga siya yung nasa formula natin. In this case, yung a is yung katabi ng x squared. In this case, anong katabi ng x squared? That is 12, or that is 12, right? Yung b dito is equal to yung katabi ng x, right? Katabi ng x is 7. And then, of course, yung c, be careful with your sign, yan yung constant, negative 12. Again, be careful with your sign. Okay? Then, since na-identify na natin yung A, B, and C, we can actually substitute that in our formula. So, that would be X equals yung negative copy. Again, negative copy. Yung B is 7. Okay? Plus, minus, square root of B squared is still 7 squared. Kasi nga, B is 7, B squared, 7 squared. Okay? Minus 4, ano yung A? A is 12, right? And then, ano yung B? B is, ano yung C? C is negative 12. Okay? And then, all over 2 times A na 12. Diba? That is how you solve this one. And then, proceed tayo. So, this will be x squared equals negative 7, copy, sorry, wala tayong square dito. Negative 7 plus minus square root of 7 squared is 49, okay? Minus, negative times positive, negative times negative is positive. 12 times 12 is 144. 144 times 4 is equal to 16 carry 1, 16, 17 carry 1, 576. So this one is 500, this one is supposed to be 49 kasi 7 squared is 49. And then plus 576. So 576. Okay? That is all over 2 times 12 is 24. Okay? So that is 24. Now, in this case, we are going to solve yung nasa loob ng square root sign or radical sign. That is negative 7 plus minus square root of, that is 625. Right? 5 carry 1, 8, 2 carry 1, 625. Divided by 24. Kuha? And then, that would be, balik tayo dito. So, copy lang, students. So that is x equals negative 7. Negative 7 plus minus, ano yung square root ng 625? That is equal to 25, right? Kasi 25 times, so, tama ba? 25 times 25 is 625, tama. So that is 25. All over 2 times, that is 24, okay? So that is our solution, but we're not done yet. We still have to combine the numbers there. So that would be x equals negative 7. First is gamitin natin yung plus 25 all over 24. Okay? Plus muna tayo, mag-focus muna tayo sa plus. So x would be equal to negative 7 plus 25, how much is that? That would be negative 18 over 24. Right? Negative 18 over 24. And reduce that to lowest term, that is equal to, let's say that is, factor nila is 6, right? 6, that is negative 3, 4. Okay? Students, this is just one of the answer. However, yung ginamit pala natin is plus. We still have minus here. So that will be equal to, wait lang. Yeah, hindi pa natin ginagamit yung minus. I hope it's clear. I'll just go and erase this one. Dito naman tayo sa kabila. First base. Now again, students, plus pa lang yung nagamit natin, hindi pa natin nagamit yung minus, so we will use the minus one. X is equal to negative 7 minus 25. Okay? Kasi plus dun, dito minus over 24. Okay? And that would be equal to X is negative 7 minus 25 is... Oh, sorry, students. Sorry. This should be positive. This should be positive 35. Kasi nga mas malaki yung 25. And this part, that is negative 32 divided by 24. Ano yung GCF nila? That is X equals negative. Yung GCF nila is 8. 32 divided 8 is 4. Over 24 divided 8 is 3. So 4 thirds. Therefore, our solution is negative 4 thirds and positive 3 fourths. Okay.